Often, we tend to criticize other people, even mock them, often just thinking they're crazy. How else would you call someone who has been digging a canal by hand for 11 years straight? Only an obsessed madman. There is no other way. In fact, the man named Longhi, who wanted to save his village from extinction and was considered insane by everyone around him, lived with the same perception of himself for many years. Find out how this turned out in the end. Living in the Indian village of Katilava, Longhi Poyan's life was not an easy one, as he had to literally survive in his village by working at pastures, farms, or local construction sites. He never managed to buy a good house or even one tractor to work in the fields, and in general, no villager could boast of the gifts of fortune, as the main problem had always been a lack of water, for which he had to spend most of his savings and get it from neighboring towns. The fact is that most of the rainfall fell on the nearby hills and simply flowed into a muddy river a few tens of kilometers away from the settlement. For this reason, most of the locals were forced out of their homes. The village, which had existed for decades, was dying out before their eyes and was turning into a wasteland. But even though our hero's four children had also moved to better settlements, the old man himself never thought of leaving home. Later, he would say something like this: "In just 1 year, our neighbors and friends had left us. I even had to accept the departure of my children, but I could not do as they did because I was born here and this is my home. Of course, one could just complain about fate. What else could they do?" That's what all the villagers did, but not our hero. He decided to take matters into his own hands and dig a whole canal to bring water from the hills to a small pond near the village. Initially, Longhi invited all willing men to help in his endeavors, but the locals did not take the man's word seriously, believing him to be insane. Later, they even started mocking the old man's efforts, while continuing to mind their own business and complaining about their lives. This is how the man's fame as a madman was cemented. Even his wife did not support her husband's idea, threatening to move in with the children. But even that did not stop our builder. He started his work in the mid-80s and daily got up at dawn to head for the hills again to dig a trench. It didn't matter at all whether the weather was hot or pouring, he worked every day with his usual shovel or pickaxe. Every day he would spend about 5 to 7 hours on this work, plus 2 hours on the road, and after that he would go home and do his direct duties of looking after the cattle, the town, and so on. Some may say it was just another idea of an obsessive fanatic, but Longhi was sure of what he was doing. In his first year, the man was able to dig about 600 meters of trench. Often he had to deal not with the ground, but with the rocks. It took a lot of effort. When the first trench was ready, Longhi was in for a shock. One day, a strong wind cut the reinforcement of the canal, and the old man had to dig out the new area anew and devise a foolproof reinforcement system. The man then fell ill, putting him out of action for 6 months and seriously compromising his health. But the hard worker had no intention of giving up. Time passed, and each year the trench grew longer and wider. It's hard to believe, but over the course of 3 decades, the already aging enthusiast was able to dig it 1.5 to 3 meters wide and 1.5 meters deep. At the same time, it was as much as 15 kilometers long. The old man worked hard every day to make his dreams come true and bring hope to the inhabitants of his village, which had become rather desolate over the years. When everything was ready, Longhi dug the last stretch near the hills and water flowed down the new canal. It was a true miracle, as with no special training, he was able to calculate everything so that the water would flow directly to the villages and the fields for planting. The locals were astonished, as no one believed in the idea. From then on, Longhi was no longer considered a freak, but a true hero. Today, about 3,000 people benefit from the work of this elderly man. Once the canal became operational, the village was transformed and trees and vegetables started to grow again. In addition, neighboring settlements are also benefiting from the water. And what did our hero receive for his titanic work tinged with applause? A local businessman, having heard about this story, presented the old man with a new tractor. Some may say it wasn't worth the hard labor, but as Longhi himself says, his aim was not to get famous or rich, but to save the village from extinction and give the villagers hope for a good life. He has no hard feelings and lets everyone use the water. Ever since this story leaked on social media, users have been blaming the Indian authorities for not paying attention to the problem in time and not supporting Longhi. There has also been talk of compensating the man for his titanic efforts with a more substantial gift. but the humble pensioner keeps reminding us that he doesn't look at all like someone who needs money and fame. He also jokes that if his idea had not worked, hardly anyone would have stood up for him. It was personally my idea, so I don't think it's necessary to give me any gifts. Today, I am just glad that everything worked out. But this story proves once again that even one is a warrior in the field, because a simple man was able to provide water not only for himself and his village, but also for several neighboring settlements by sticking to the plan every day. Only tenacious and persistent people can create truly great things. I think Longi belongs among them. Friends, what do you think of the old man's idea? Write in the comments. And that's it for today. Like this video and talk to you soon. Bye.